Hi, in this video we will talk about the TurboSmooth modifier. I will divide this tutorial into two parts. And in the first part we will talk about how the TurboSmooth works and what it does. Here we have this plane with one polygon. I will add the TurboSmooth modifier. I will press F4 to see the edges, the wireframe version. So here, with iteration 1, this polygon is subdivided into 4 polygons. If I increase the iterations to 2, each one of those 4 polygons created with the first iteration will be further subdivided into 4. So at the beginning we had 1. With 1 iteration we have 4, and with 2 we have 16, and so on. So if I increase the iterations to 3, each one of those 16 will be subdivided into 4 polygons. Now, I will add an edit poly modifier. So I will click this edge and shift and drag. Now we have 2 polygons. I will add a turbo smooth. So with 1 iteration, the first polygon is subdivided into 4 and the second one into 4. But as you can see, the topology is not changing. It's still flat. The reason for that is that these 2 polygons, the angle between them is 0. You can imagine a perpendicular line going up from this polygon and another vertical line, a perpendicular line that belongs to this polygon. Those two perpendicular lines are parallel. You can imagine them parallel. That means the angle between them is 0. In this scenario, the topology doesn't change. So here, what I will do, I will go to edge and I will move this edge up. So now you can imagine this perpendicular line and this perpendicular line. Now the angle between them is bigger than 0. In this case, when I activate the turbo smooth, you can see that the topology is changing. When the angle between them is bigger than 0, you can imagine, you can consider this shape here is like a curve, a very rough curve that goes from here to here. So when you increase the iteration here, the transition between this point and this point is happening with 4 polygons. Iteration 2, it's happening with 8 polygons, so it becomes smoother. Now, again, I will turn off this and I will go to edge. I will select those 2 edges, press shift. As you can see, the transition is happening from this side, but if we look here in this direction, it's still flat. And that's because the angle between those polygons, between this one and this one, is 0, and between this one and this one is 0. So no change is happening in this direction. Again, I will go here and I will move these edges up. Now the angle between this one and this one is bigger than 0 in this direction. Also, between this one and this one is bigger than 0. So if I activate the Turbo Smooth, the topology is changing in both directions. Now, based on what we've learned, suppose that I don't want this transition to be from here to here. I want this part to be flat and this part to be flat, and only I want the topology to change somewhere here. So what I can do, I will go to Edge, I will select those three edges, I will click on the settings for the connect tool, I will slide this newly created edges to here, click OK, and then I will select those three edges and do the same. Now, if I activate the Turbo Smooth, now before I do that, let's imagine what will happen. Between this polygon and this polygon, the angle is zero, so from here to here, it will stay flat. Same thing between those two here, and also between this one and this one, and this one and this one. The transition, the change in topology will happen in this area because this polygon and this polygon, the angle between them is bigger than zero. Same thing here. Let's try that. See, this part stays flat, also this part, and now we create something like a fillet. The edge that we the edges that we created, generally when you watch tutorials, they are called support edges. Now, when you see a very complex shapes like a model of a hand or a face or something, and you see lots of polygons, and you might think that the artist just created all these polygons. Well, actually, these complex forms, they start basically with rough shapes. And then you add a Turbo Smooth, and you start to add these support edges to constrain the smoothness, the transitions. Of course, other things are involved in creating those complex shapes, like moving around vertices and stuff like that, but this is something very essential. I will end this tutorial, this part of Turbo Smooth tutorial, talking about something you might hear a lot when you watch tutorials for professionals, and that is they tell you always to keep your polygons as quads. Quads means a polygon made of four edges. Now, there is a reason for that. Here I have two shapes that are similar. The difference is that this one is made of quads, this one is made of a mixture of quads and triangles. Now, I will start with this one. If I add, now here you can see that, you can see those quads, that you have rows and columns, say. If I add a Turbo Smooth, you can see that we still have the same logic here. We have these quads going in rows and columns. Basically, the result is predictable. On the other hand, for this one, if I add a Turbo Smooth, this polygon will be subdivided to four, and this triangle here will also be subdivided into four. So we will not have this clean rows and columns of polygons that are, you know, there will be, it will be unpredictable how the topology will change. I will add the turbo smooth now. You can see that, well, you might like the result. If this is what you want, it's not a problem. You don't have to feel that you did something fundamentally wrong. But let's say that the topology here will be less predictable. This one, I know beforehand that how things will turn out. But in this one, no. So just keep this in mind. It's not about some technical reason, and no, it's about how predictable it will be. And that's it for this tutorial. I will make another tutorial for TurboSmooth also. There are other features, other options here that we need to talk about. For now, that's it, and thank you for watching.